Hello and welcome to the SAP HANA Academy. My name is Sebastian Schmidt and in this video tutorial we will discuss sizing for SAP HANA, sizing new greenfield requirements using the SAP HANA QuickSizer tool. This video shall give you an overview about the usage of the sizing tool QuickSizer. It briefly summarizes the most important features and shall enable you a smooth start if you're using QuickSizer for the first time. The HANA QuickSize is a tool that was developed by SAP in close cooperation with its hardware partners. The tool is free of charge and is mainly used by SAP customers and partners. If you go to www.service.sap.com/quicksizer, you see on the right side two boxes called Start QuickSizer Classic Version and HANA Version. If you want to do a SAP HANA sizing, then you should click on the second box. By clicking on HANA version, the HANA QuickSizer entry page will appear. As you can see, you will have several possibilities on this page. You can create a new sizing project, change or just display an existing one, create a reference project, or show your projects in which you were working on. For some applications, the sizing team from SAP has created example projects, which shall make your life easier in entering data into the tool. You can also find on this page a link to a document that is called QuickSizer for Beginners, which is highly recommended if you're new to QuickSizer. If you decide to create a new project, you have to enter your customer number and a project name. It's important to know that everyone who has the combination of customer number and project name can enter your project, unless you have restricted the access. Once you have entered the customer number and your project name, you can create a new sizing project. Please note that the look and feel of the classical QuickSizer and the HANA QuickSizer is the same. There are differences in terms of sizable applications, and the calculation algorithm are somehow different. As mentioned, you can limit the user access by clicking on the button Limit User Access. By doing so, you make sure that only selected people can access the project. Basically, the QuickSizer is built on three parts. On the left side, there is the input navigation tree. On the upper right side, you have some project-wide information, and the main part is the respective sizing questionnaire below. As a first step, you should choose the application on the left side. As you can see, there are applications from the SAP Business Suite powered by SAP HANA, analytical solutions, industry solutions, and different usage types from SAP NetWeaver. Not all of SAP's applications are part of QuickSizer. For some applications, such as applications that are based on SAP HANA, SAP has created sizing guidelines that are listed on the SAP Service Marketplace under Sizing Guidelines. If you choose to conduct an ERP on HANA sizing, then you click on ERP and then, for example, on Sales and Service. There you see now different sizing questionnaires. Normally, we distinguish between user-based and throughput-based sizing. Both sizing approaches are independent from each other, and you can enter your data either in the user-based or throughput-based questionnaire. Of course, you can also enter your input in both questionnaires. Let's spend some words about the two sizing approaches. If you want to do a sizing for users working in sales and distribution, you have the possibility to determine the activity pattern. In QuickSizer, three different activity patterns were implemented. It is distinguished between low activity users with a sync time of 300 seconds, medium activity users with 30 seconds, and high activity user with a sync time of 10 seconds. Please note that concurrently active users are the type of users who have to be entered into the tool. To give you a valid forecast about the required disk space, you also have to determine how long your data shall remain in the database. Therefore, you can specify the residence time. The user-based sizing is very straightforward and data can be entered pretty easily. The biggest challenge is to find out the concurrency of the users. Let's enter some numbers into the different boxes. 1,000 low activity users, 500 medium activity users, and 20 high active users. And we also assume a think time of 12 months. In parallel, you can work on your throughput-based sizing. It might be a little bit more difficult to get the numbers as compared to the user numbers. The biggest difference is that you have the possibility to include peak times into your sizing, which is marked with a P. A stands for average. For the sake of convenience, let's conduct an ERP sales and service sizing. As you can see, you have the chance to enter the sales orders and the respective line items that have to be processed in a predefined time period. Apart from that, you can define the number of changes and displays to an object in percent. If you have, for example, 10 million sales orders per year with 10 line items per order, and your assumption is that all orders are being changed one time and that half of the orders are being displayed one time, then you have to enter 100 in the field changes in percent and 50 in the field displays in percent. You also have the chance to define the retention period and, as already mentioned, the average working day and the peak time. This easy example is of course not very realistic because a typical business scenario as it is implemented at customer side includes much more scenarios, but it's absolutely sufficient to show you the way how Quicksizer normally works. So let's have a look what Quicksizer has calculated and how the result page looks like. If you click on Calculate Result, you normally get two results. One for the user-based sizing, the other for the throughput-based sizing. In both cases, you get a result for CPU in subs, memory in megabyte, and disk in gigabyte. If you have chosen your inputs well, then the difference in the results is pretty small. If there's a big difference, this might be an indication that something with your own input is not correct. In this case, you should go back to your sizing project team, which typically consists of people working in IT infrastructure, business department, and implementation, and discuss the inputs again more in detail. By the way, you should always make sure that these stakeholders are part of the sizing project. You also have the possibility to check other result levels. If you have, for example, very complex Quicksizer project with many different input values and you would like to investigate where the major resource drivers are, then you can drill down to the different result levels for further analysis. Before concluding this brief Quicksizer introduction video, let's spend some words about the typical sizing process. After the completion of the Quicksizer project, customers usually want to get a proposal from hardware vendor. To facilitate the communication to hardware vendors, there's a link in Quicksizer which provides a list of email addresses or online templates to get in contact with hardware partners quick and easy. Of course, Quicksizer has much more functionalities which couldn't be introduced in this video. If you're interested to learn more about Quicksizer, please have a look at the documentation on the SAP Service Marketplace. Thank you for watching this SAP HANA Academy video.